Hello viewers, welcome back to our YouTube channel Don Bosco School Tinsukia. Today I am going to solve some problems based on circles. So question is, a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center at a point Q so that OQ equal to 12 cm. If so, find the length of PQ. So at first our work is to understand the question, what is telling in the question. Part by part if we read, we will get the meaning. A tangent PQ at a point P. So PQ, this diagram if we take PQ, it is a tangent at P, that means P must be the point of contact. So how to understand? P is the point of contact, P will be here, not here. This we can get idea from this sentence, a tangent PQ at a point P. So, at a point P, from there we can understand P should be the point of contact of a circle of radius 5 cm, that means radius of the circle is 5 cm. So, OP, here it is radius and its length is how much? 5 cm as per question. Meets a line through the center at a point Q. So, from the center, if we join this tangent at a point Q, meets a line. So that means on joining O and Q, we get the length of OQ as 12 cm. So two things we are given. We are given the length of radius and we are given this OQ. Now, what is this OQ? Try to understand it. Now, OPQ, what type of triangle is it? If you saw my previous videos, there I proved that tangent is perpendicular to the radius, or you can say radius is perpendicular to the tangent, same thing at the point of contact. So if radius is perpendicular to the tangent, that means this angle's measure is how much? Yes, yes, it is 90 degree. This symbol itself means this angle's measure is 90 degree. So here we have got one right angle triangle in which we are given the length of this perpendicular OP. And the side opposite to the right angle is our hypotenuse. That means we are given the length of hypotenuse OQ. If it is, then what thing we are asked to find? Then find the length of PQ. That means PQ, this tangent's length, here we will have to find. So, solution. Here, let us write these values here at first. OP equal to 5 cm and OQ equal to 12 cm. How this angle is 90 degree, how this triangle is a right angle triangle, all this we are not going to explain because when it will come in exam, it will carry hardly one mark. So, in short only we will do. All these things in detail we are not going to write. So, by applying Pythagoras theorem, we can find this PQ's length. So, by applying Pythagoras theorem, in short, we can write it as PGT. In which triangle? In right triangle OPQ, we get, what do we get? Pythagoras theorem tells that in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of the other two sides. So, square of the hypotenuse, that means OQ square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides, means OP square plus PQ square. So, we can write here at first OP square plus PQ square. So, this is perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. What is the name of the hypotenuse? It is OQ. So, OQ square. Now, just substitute the values, whatever we are available here. OP how much? It is 5 cm. So, 5, right? You need, no need to write. We can write just 5 square. PQ, do you know the length of PQ? No. In fact, we are going to find the length of PQ. So, PQ, let it remain same. PQ square, it will remain same. And right hand side, OQ. Do you know the value of OQ? How much? It is 12 cm. So, in place of OQ, we can write now 12. And square will remain same in its own place. So, OQ square means 12 square. I hope you have already written this. Let me do it. Now, 5 square. 5 square will give how much? 5 square gives us 25 plus PQ square, it will remain same in its own place, equal to right hand side 12 square. 12 square gives us 144. Our aim is to get the value of PQ. So, for that reason, PQ square will remain alone in left hand side and 25 will send to right hand side. So, PQ square equal to 144 minus 25. So, PQ square is equal to 144 minus 25, 14 minus 5, it will be 9. Then here 3 minus 2, 1, then 1, 119. So, PQ square is equal to 119. Now, PQ equal to how much? Therefore, PQ equal to square root you have to take. So, square root if we take, it will become 119. Whenever we take square root, actually before square root plus minus both sign comes. But here we don't need, because length of one of the sides of a triangle cannot be negative. So, minus root 119, it is not possible only. So, I have not written here plus minus sign directly. I have written as root 119. It should be positive value only. So, therefore, the required length of the tangent is PQ. So, which is our answer? Because we are asked find the length of PQ, we have got PQ equal to root 119. Now, I will take another question. TP and TQ are two tangents to a circle with center O, so that angle POQ is equal to 110 degree, then find angle PTQ. We will have to find angle PTQ. So, first of all, we are given here TP and TQ are two tangents to a circle with center O. So, here in diagram, you can see TP and TQ, they are two tangents to a circle with center, name is O. Also, we are given angle POQ's measure 110 degree, it is already written here. And now, we will have to find angle PTQ. PTQ, can you see? This PTQ, this angle's measure we will have to find. So, to find angle PTQ's measure, once again we have to recall that first theorem what we proved in other video, that tangent is perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact. The tangent is perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact. TP being a tangent and OP being a radius, so TP should be perpendicular to OP, or we can say OP is perpendicular to TP. Thereby we will get angle OPT equal to how much? It is 90 degree. And for the same reason, angle OQT, that angle's measure is also 90 degree. So, we can write here solution. Here angle OPT that is equal to angle OQT is equal to 90 degree. Angle OPT equal to angle OQT equal to 90 degree. Why? For what reason? The tangent is perpendicular to the radius. A tangent is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. A tangent is perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact, So, reason is a tangent is perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact. For that reason, we are getting angle OPT equal to angle OQT is equal to 90 degree. So, these two angles measure is 90 degree, this one 90 degree and this one also 90 degree. Now, look at this diagram very carefully. This diagram here we are getting one quadrilateral. See TPOQ, it becomes a quadrilateral. And there, just if we apply angle sum property of a quadrilateral, that will give the measure of angle PTQ. So, have you remembered the property of that quadrilateral? According to that property of quadrilateral, the sum of angle sum property of a quadrilateral, of course, the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral equal to how much? 360 degrees. So, that property we are going to apply now. So, by applying Engelsum property in quadrilateral TPOQ we get. So by applying Engelsum property of a quadrilateral we get what shall we get? What is the name of the quadrilateral here? Name of the quadrilateral is TPOQ. So sum of these four angles will be equal to how much? 360 degrees. So we can write angle PTQ plus angle TPO, or we can write it as OPT also. Since here we have written OPT, so better to write it as OPT. Same thing, but we can write OPT. OPT plus this angle. We can write it as TQO also, but here written OQT, so better to write OQT. So OQT plus, so we have written this angle, this one and this one. These three have already written. Now this last angle. What is the name of this angle? POQ is equal to 360 degree. Now just we will substitute the values. PTQ, we are going to find that value, so it will remain same. PTQ it will remain same. Now OPT from here we can write 90 degree plus angle OQT, once again from here we can write 90 degree plus angle POQ. It is given in the question itself. Angle POQ's measure we are given how much? 110 degree. Angle POQ we are given as 110 degree. So in place of angle POQ, 110 degree. It is given in the question itself. Is equal to 360 degree. Angle PTQ, it will remain same, plus add all these three angles, 90 plus 110, that will give 200 plus 90, 290. So 290 degree equal to 360 degree. Then in next line, 290 degree will send to right hand side, it will become minus. In left hand side, we will be left with PTQ equal to 360 degree minus 290 degree. So angle PTQ, it will remain same in its own place. Now 360 minus 290, what shall we get? Yes, it is 70 degrees. So 70 degree, which angles measure? PTQ. So PTQ we have got as 70 degree. So which is our answer? This question also often comes as multiple choice. So if you know the technique, very easily you can solve it. Now I'll take another question. Question is, a quadrilateral ABCD is drawn to circumscribe a circle. Then we have to prove AB plus CD equal to AD plus BC. So one quadrilateral is there, ABCD, it is a quadrilateral and it is circumscribing a circle. Try to get the meaning of circumscribing. So circumscribing means that circle should be inside the quadrilateral, and the sides of the quadrilateral should touch, each side of the quadrilateral should touch the circle at distinct points. So here we can see side AB, it is touching at one point. Side BC, it is touching the circle at one point. Similarly, CD side also touching at one point, and this DA side is also touching another point. So this touching points names are not given, that one we will suppose ourselves. So let the sides AB, BC, CD and DA, let the sides AB, BC touching or intersecting, same thing. Let the sides AB, BC, CD and DA intersect intersect the circle at the points. What are the name of the points? I have supposed here P, Q, R and S. So at the points P, Q, R and S respectively. So I have supposed myself that let the sides AB, BC, CD and DA intersect the circle at the points P, Q, R and S respectively. So side AB intersecting the circle at P, side BC intersecting at Q, side CD intersecting at R and side DA intersecting at S. Then what to prove? To prove we will have to write. That one always you have to write to prove. Looking at question we can write AB plus CD. AB plus CD is equal to what? AD plus BC. Right hand side is AD plus BC. So here no construction is required, directly we can start our proof. Now look, for this circle A is an external point and from this external point we can say AP is a tangent. Similarly AS is also a tangent. So in my last video I proved that the tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal in lengths. So according to that theorem we can say here AP equal to AS. Similarly we will get BP equal to BQ because B is also an external point and BP is a tangent. Similarly BQ is also tangent, so BP and BQ are also equal. More we will get CQ and CR are equal and DS and DR are equal and all these things reason is same. What is that reason? Reason is the tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal in length. So that one at first we will write. We know that tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal in lengths. Are equal in lengths. From one point two tangents we can draw here AP and AS and the length of these two tangents are equal. So that is I have written here. We know that tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal in length. So here external points, there are four external points A, B, C and D. For all these four points, from all these four points tangents are drawn. So we'll get therefore what? Write it quickly. I'll have to erase. You can take the screenshot. Okay. So what are the name of the tangents? I can write AP equal to AS. AP equal to AS. Then B being an external point, so from here we'll get BP equal to BQ. BP equal to BQ. Let us give number, this one 1, 2, then from here CR equal to CQ. CR equal to CQ, number 3 and number 4, which one is left? Now this one, DR equal to DS. DR equal to DS, it is number 4. For all these four things the reason is same and that reason is tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal in lengths. You have to keep your eyes what we are asked to prove. Our aim is to get this thing that AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. Now see how we can get AB here. Here some grouping we need to do. After grouping, we'll get AB. So look at the diagram and see how we can get AB at first. So if we add AP and BP, if we add AP and BP, then shall we not get AB? Yes, we'll get AP and BP. AP means from here to here and BP means this part. So these two, if we add, so that will give the full line segment whose name is AB. So we'll add 1 and 2. So 1 and 2 we'll add now, so that we can get AB. Now 1 plus 2 implies. So left hand side plus left hand side is equal to right hand side plus right hand side. So AP plus BP, AP plus BP is equal to right hand side what? AS plus BQ. AS plus BQ. This implies AP plus BP. From diagram, it is very much clear to us. If we add AP and BP, that will give us AB. So in place of these two things, we can write now AB. And right hand side AS plus BQ. Where is our AS? AS is this one and plus BQ. So they are two different line segments. We cannot add them. Let them remain same. AS plus BQ. Let them remain same. So for numbering we have used 1, 2, 3, 4. So let us give this one number 5. Again, remaining two also we'll add 3 and 4. 3 and 4 we'll add. See what we'll get if we add 3 and 4. So left hand side of 3 and 4 if we add, that will give us CR plus DR. So look at this diagram, CR plus DR. If we add these two segments, which segment shall we get? We'll get CD segment. And it is there in left hand side of what we are asked to prove. So now we'll add this 3 and 4. So again 3 plus 4 implies. 3 plus 4 implies. So left hand side of 3 it is CR plus left hand side of 4 it is DR. CR plus DR is equal to right hand side of 3 it is CQ plus right hand side of 4 it is DS. So DS. Again look at the diagram, CR plus DR. CR plus DR, if we add these two segments, that will give us full this CD. So in place of CR plus DR, we can write CD. So let us write CD. And what about this right hand side, CQ plus DS? So CQ is this segment and DS it is this segment. So they are two different line segments, not lying on the same segment. So they will remain as they are. We cannot add. So for this time being, you keep them same, CQ plus DS. And this one you give as number 6. Yeah, write it quickly. You can take the screenshot. Okay. Again, we have to focus on what we are asked to prove. We have to get AB plus CD equal to AD plus BC. Look at left hand side of 5. Left hand side of 5, we have got AB. Left hand side of 5, we have got AB. And left hand side of 6, we have got CD. So AB plus CD. So to get AB plus CD, that means we'll have to add now 5 and 6. So now 5 plus 6 implies. This 5 and 6 now we are going to add in order to get the ultimate thing. What is that ultimate thing? AD, AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. So 5 and 6. Left hand side of 5, what is there? It is AB. So we can write AB plus left hand side of 6. What is there? CD. So CD, keep it same, equal to right hand side of 5. In right hand side of 5, what is there? It is AS plus BQ. So AS plus BQ will write. AS plus BQ plus right hand side of 6, what is there? It is CQ plus DS. CQ plus DS. So write it. And once again, you look the right hand side of what we are asked to prove. We have to get now in right hand side AD plus BC. Left hand side we have already got. It is AB plus CD. Left hand side we have already got. So we are not required to think about left hand side. Now just we have to think about right hand side. We have to get now AD plus BC. So for getting that AD plus BC, this fourth segment we have to arrange in such a way so that we can get AD and BC. So look at the diagram and see how we can get AD. On adding which two segments among these four segments, we can get AD. AD, where is our AD? This one AD. So to get AD, we need AS segment and we need DS segment. So AS and DS, do you have these two segments? Yes, they are there, AS and DS. So we'll make group with this AS and DS. So we can write AS plus DS, keep it inside one bracket, first bracket can be used for it. And with the remaining two segments, let us make another group. Remaining segments are BQ plus CQ. BQ plus CQ, keep it inside bracket. Now from diagram, if we look at the diagram, AS plus DS, AS plus DS, that will give this full segment. What is the name of the full segment? It is AD. So we can write here AD plus BQ plus CQ. Look at here, BQ plus CQ. BQ from here to here and CQ from here to here. So if we add these two segments, which segment shall we get? CB. CB or BC, same thing. So we can write here BC. Now look at the right hand side of what we are asked to prove, AD plus BC. Have we got AD plus BC? Yes, we have got AD plus BC. So altogether, we are getting what we are asked to prove. That means AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. AD plus BC. So it is our proved. I hope you have understood this video very nicely. So today we'll stop here. I hope we'll meet soon. Take care. Bye bye.